to get all the more familiar through practice and practice. All right, so let's actually.
You know, one of probably the biggest questions that we get, and we've answered in a couple of places, is why do we teach C?
You're gonna ask that question, aren't
you? I'm asking you, why do we do it?
No, it's a very conscious decision, and I actually do think it serves us well overall, and hopefully serves our students very well overall, even though we definitely pay a price, I think, in complexity sometimes. Pointers, in particular, is a particularly sophisticated subject that a lot of students understandably wrestle with. But the reality is, it's such a relatively small language. I mean, we use almost every feature syntactically and logic and even functionally of it that comes with the standard library, at least. It's pretty low level without going into assembly language, and there's really no magic, or not much magic at all. You get a little bit of help from the compiler here and there, but the reality is, like, things are not going to be in memory unless you put them in memory, and something's not going to be copied unless you copy every one of those bytes. And so there's this deliberateness to the language that I think is really helpful, because there really is so little magic.
Yeah, it gives us the opportunity to talk about things that you can't even talk about in a lot of more modern mm-hmm. high-level languages. And C, you know, has been around for a really long time. It has inspired so many of these other languages. So even a language like Python, it looks really different. It sort of still has the same flow to it, and certainly JavaScript, or when we used to teach PHP, they can all sort of count C as ancestors. And so that's another, I think, good reason to use it.
And I think I'm so proud of our students, honestly, like mid-semester, by which point we've already looked at what's going on underneath the hood, and they can speak to memory management and the stack and the heap, and they really understand functionally, like, what is going on underneath the hood, what is the runtime or the computer doing for you, what is the compiler doing for you, and having that appreciation so that when we do get closer to the end of the semester and we introduce Python and JavaScript and others, you have a much greater appreciation for and understanding of what the language is doing for you and how it's doing it.
Yeah, you can take those things for granted, but you still know what you are taking mm-hmm. for granted.
Even in Python, which has good documentation on the time complexity or running time of various data structures, algorithms like lists and sets and dictionaries and so forth, like, you can actually imagine, all right, well, how must Python be implementing some data structure in order to achieve this running time? And we've looked at that at a very low level by having students build those structures themselves. And even the security aspects, I mean, it's ridiculous, but to this day, we still suffer as a society from buffer overflow attacks and various exploits based on that. And being able to have that conversation and talk about what's going on and really demonstrating that this is a pretty low-level attack, but it all makes sense if you just understand these basics, these first principles on top of which we've been building these systems. Like, you can infer, even from that alone, how these attacks are taking advantage of systems.
Mm-hmm.